Now we're going to determine the product of radical conjugates. Conjugates are two radical expressions that are the same except one is a difference and one is a sum. For example, the quantity square root 11 minus 4 and the quantity square root 11 plus 4 are conjugates. Notice they look the same except one's a difference and one's a sum. And this product is a special product, so let's see how this works out. Again, we're going to have four products. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we can think of distributing the square root 11 and distributing a negative 4. So for square root 11 times square root of 11, that's going to be equal to the square root of 11 times 11. We'll come back and simplify this. Next we have square root of 11 times 4. We need to be careful here because this 4 is not underneath the square root, so this will be plus 4 square root 11. Next we have negative 4 times square root 11, so that's going to be minus 4 square root 11. And then we have negative 4 times positive 4, it's negative 16 or minus 16. Well, the square root of 11 times 11 is just going to be 11, so this is 11. And then when multiplying conjugates, the two middle terms should be opposites. Positive 4 square root 11 minus 4 square root 11 is going to be equal to 0 since they're opposites. So we just have 11 minus 16, which is equal to negative 5. So notice when multiplying radical conjugates that involve square roots, these square roots all simplify. Let's take a look at a second example. Again, we'll have four products. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then keep in mind, because these are conjugates, the two middle terms should be opposites. Okay, so our first product is 7 square root 3 times 7 square root 3. Well, 7 times 7 is 49. And then we'll have the square root of 3 times 3. Now I realize we could probably skip this step here and just write 3, but I'm just showing all the work. Next we have 7 square root 3 times negative 2 square root 5. So that's going to be minus 14 times the square root of 3 times 5. Next we have positive 2 square root 5 times positive 7 square root 3. That's going to be plus 14 times the square root of 5 times 3. And then the last product we have, 2 square root 5 times negative 2 square root 5, is going to be minus 4 times the square root of 5 times 5. Now let's simplify. This is a perfect square. So here we're going to have 49 times 3. Notice how these two middle terms, again, are opposites. This is negative 14 square root 15 plus 14 square root 15, which is 0. And then the last term, this is a perfect square. So we have minus 4 times 5. Well, 49 times 3 is equal to 147 minus 20. So this simplifies to 127. So again, notice when our radical conjugate involves square roots, the product simplified so it did not contain any square roots. I hope you found this helpful.